Hello all, today we would like to present to you the respiration rate measurement at the corpuls3 via pulse oximetry. If the option is licensed for the user, the device can evaluate the pleth curve in normal, pulse oximetry, and obtain the respiration rate. This is then continuously displayed, and it works even without capnography connected. Verena will now show us quickly how to find the corresponding field on the display and what we can configure there.
To display the pleth curve, we have to connect first, of course, the pulse oximetry sensor to the patient available at Corpuls. It also does not matter if we take the ear sensor, the finger clip, or an adhesive sensor. When we have done this, we have to wait a bit until the device shows a value. We can see it down here. For one, you can recognise by the blue colour and here by the word pleth that the value is generated by pulse oximetry. If we want to change that, for example, if we also connect a capnography sensor, we can open the context menu and then change the priority from oximetry to CO2. And you can see that the field is now purple for capnography and it says CO2 up here. If we have now set the priority to the CO2 curve, but no capnography sensor is connected yet to the patient, only the pulse oximetry sensor the device still recognises automatically and does not show the capnography curve, but the pleth curve.
The pleth curve is very important for respiration rate measurement. So to make sure that it is displayed correctly, the pulse oximetry sensor must be the appropriate size for the patient and be attached at the correct measuring site. We should avoid having motion artifacts and artifacts produced by too bright light. Also, a bad peripheral perfusion can influence the measurement or even make measurements impossible.
And in addition to the points Andi just mentioned, there are further interference sources in pulse oximetry, which we have to consider here as well, of course. But we are talking about that in a whole separate video. You can find it on our channel under pulse oximetry. But it is important to mention that this all does not work as apnea monitoring for patients. It is crucial to always have an eye on the patient yourselves. We also recommend to count the respiration rate yourself first. I think in total, it is a very good tool to display the respiration rate really continuously so you can detect a development and do not have to attach another thing to the patient. We hope we could give you some practical tips here. Wishes, questions, suggestions into the comments below. We appreciate it. Click on the bell so you don't miss anything. Till next time.
Bye.